In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to connect your buildings with the all-new Toposolids in Revit 2024. We're going to start off by cutting Toposolids with foundations, walls, and floors. Then I'm going to be showing you how to use voids to create openings in the Toposolids for the underground levels. And then finally, I'm going to be showing you how to create and represent excavation work inside of Revit 2024 with Toposolids. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So if you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of dedicated Revit tutorials explaining all of the interesting and complicated topics in Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and I have this section. You can see we have this smaller house, and then we have the Toposolid below. And now we want to basically connect our house with the Toposolid, because at the moment, as you can see, they're basically overlapping. So what you want to do is you just want to go here to cut geometry. You can select multiple cut. You can then click on the Toposolid, and then you can just use your cursor to basically cut out these foundations and also the floor from that Toposolid. Now in this section, now we have pretty much done the work. You can notice that the Toposolid is cut because the cut lines of the Toposolid are quite thick, so you can kind of figure out that it's actually being cut over here. However, I like to double check everything by going to the 3D view. And then I can basically select the Toposolid. I can go here to temporary height isolate and basically isolate this element. And as you can see, this is what we have. So basically we have the foundations running this way. But if you just want to double check, you can always reset temporary height isolate, select the Toposolid, and then let's see. Okay, so as you can see, we're missing three of these foundations and walls. And for that, we can just go to wireframe, and then again go to cut geometry, make sure multiple cut is selected, select that Toposolid, and then click on this foundation here, here, and here. And we also have that foundation wall here, here, and here. Now, this is a little bit hard to see, but when it's your project, you're going to know what's where. So now I can just go back to hidden line. I can again go to temporary height isolate. First, let's select this element. Isolate element, and as you can see, now we have basically the openings in the Toposolid for the exact elements that are there. So we're now going to have kind of accurate representation of what's going on and how much earth is there, and so on. So that's basically how you cut elements from the Toposolid. Now let's explore what to do when you have underground levels. Now for this demonstration, I have this balcony model. This is from my previous tutorial, so check it out if you're interested in seeing how to create these cool sloped balconies. But if I open up the section of this building, you can see we have some underground walls and floors, but we also have this level. So even if I go here to modify and then go to cut, select this, and then remove the floors and walls from the topography, I still have the issue of earth basically being inside the building. So how do you solve this? Well, you can use a void and cut it out. So for that void, it can be a family, it can be a massing, or it can even be in place family, which is something that I prefer. So what I'm going to do for this particular project is go to level underground minus one. And then here we can see what's going on. We have underground minus two as well. So basically this is the underground level. So now I can go here to architecture, go to component, expand the menu, and select model in place. For the category, I like to pick the Toposolid, just because that's the category of the element which we're cutting. Click OK here, and then we can just create a void extrusion in this case. You can use pick lines and just pick kind of the outer lines of this building, just like that. Go all the way around, And then I'm going to use trim and extend to corner to fix these two situations up here. Okay, hit finish. And then you can go back to that section and you can see, okay, that's over here. So I can just extend it up like that. So in this case, it should be like this, I think. Okay, yeah, that looks good. And now we can just go here to cut, select the topo surface, select that void. And now, as you can see, when I hit finish model, basically we have an opening there. So there's no longer earth in our basement levels. So everything now looks correct. And now I'm going to be showing you how to create a proper excavation. So basically, when you have a building like this, you wouldn't necessarily cut down for the foundation. That wouldn't make any sense. Usually you would excavate a bit of earth like this, usually at an angle on the sides so it doesn't cave in. And then you would fill that in. And usually you want to have different representation graphically for the earth that's been filled in from the earth that was already there. So how do you do this with Toposolids? So my approach is to create first a void. So for that, I'm just going to go here to the architecture tab, then go to the component and go to model in place. Here, I'm going to pick out Toposolid. Toposolid 1, that's okay. Then I'm going to navigate to level 1. And then for this void, I'm just going to pick the void blend. And then let's create a rectangle that's going to be just a little bit around the house like this. Then let's go to edit top. And for the top, I'm going to use a rectangle and let's set this to perhaps 100 centimeters. And then let's create that offset like so, hit finish. And now we can go back to our section and we can extend this down. And basically this is what that excavation would look like. Now I'm having trouble placing it correctly. Okay, this would work. Finally, you just want to go here to cut geometry, click on the Toposolid, click on the void, and basically this is what we get now. Hit the escape key a few times and hit finish. And now we have the proper excavation around the house. Now you want to fill that in. So for that, what I'll do is I'm going to go back into level 1. Now I'm going to go to architecture or go to massing and site, go to Toposolid. And then I'm going to create another Toposolid just over here. Hit finish. And then don't attach, go to the 3D view. This is what that looks like. In the section, it looks like this. So let's switch it to this other Toposolid and also let's move it down here just like that. So it's basically overlapping. Okay, so now I'm going to change this Toposolid. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go here to edit type. I'm going to duplicate this Toposolid and let's call it Toposolid new. Click OK. Then what you can do is you can go here into structure and then go to earth. And I'm just going to duplicate this material and create earth new. And I'm just going to assign a different cut pattern. So here I'm going to use vertical lines. So I'm just going to pick these and also let's make them gray. So just like that, hit apply. OK. OK again. And also I can make it a bit I can change the thickness, perhaps 200. Okay. And then here for the coarse scale fill pattern, I'm just going to apply that same override just because I prefer to have that look no matter the detail level. Then you want to hit apply. Okay, and now it looks like this. So now what you can do is you can go to the modify tab, you can go to cut geometry, and then you want to cut this geometry with this, and that's what this looks like now. And then finally you can cut these elements out, so just like this, and now we have a proper excavation a representation graphically here in the section view. And this is usually how you would approach building this building and integrating it with the earth. So I hope you like this video. If you have any other approaches, please share with me in the comment section below. And also if you want to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.